one thing a railroad probably needs to make it look a little bit more lived in, I guess, is people. You can buy, you know, packages of people from Model Power or Lifelike or whatever, like these. Like this good. Crank. There we go. Like these guys. They're like two colors, three colors, just slapped on by factory workers. Not very good. I mean, just pretty rough. I mean, they'll do the job, but for these, what is it, 2, 4, 6 dudes, they're probably 10 or 15 bucks in the stores, something like that. I haven't even looked for years. But you can get the same guys unpainted. Let's see if we can spot some of those guys in here. Oh, sure. Now that I'm looking for them, where are they? There we go. There's Shovel Guy. Can you see him? So, he's one of the standard ones. You can also get packages of undecorated random people. I've got a set of passengers in here, which is not all that helpful for me, because I'm not doing a passenger layout. But I mean, some people be wandering around town with purses or whatever, packages, bags. There's a downhill skier. I'm not quite sure what set he's from, but there is a set of you can get of workers. Here's just a guy with a backpack, and there's all kinds of them. But yeah, here's the guy with the lantern. But you can get all kinds of them, and they're about a quarter of the price or less if you buy them unpainted. They're relatively affordable, and you can do your own paint job on them so that they don't look all the same. So if you got a bunch of different guys, like is the bucket guy in here? No, he isn't. Anyway, there's a guy that I painted, just carrying a bucket. I gave him a hard hat, and it's not much better than the job that the Chinese factory workers did with this set, but it looks different. I give him a bit of hair, and when I'm painting them, I like to give them a pin for a handle. That way, since I'm using foam on my layout, I just spike them in wherever I want them. And there they are. If I decide to move them, I can pull them up and move them. Different construction worker carrying a toolbox. Oh yeah, he's one of the ones from this set here. So all of a sudden, if I put him with his buddy, with the rag, in different areas, it doesn't look like I got all the same guy. I'm going to also modify them a little bit, and I think I'm going to do that to one of them that I'm working on here today. But these guys in here are, some of them are pre-painted, some of them are ones that I've painted. And what's that? Oh, there's a hiker dude with a stick. Huh, there's one that I'm partway through painting who's similar, not exactly the same guy. But he's got a hiking stick. I'll do something with him. This guy over here seems to be a popular one in these sets too. Guy with bottle. In this case, guy with hard hat with bottle. The guy in this, he originally comes with a pickaxe. I took this guy's pickaxe off just so that I can park him outside a bar or something, so he doesn't look like a construction worker is drinking on the job, which in itself is humorous, but how many of those do you need for reality? So, let's change the focus on the camera a little bit and get busy. So let's work with this guy here. First thing I want to do is put him on a pin like these guys, just to give him a handle. So I use a little tiny drill. These are usually called a pin vise. I guess because it's got an end that you can stick a pin in. This one's got a tiny little drill bit in it, which I already measured. It's the same gauge more or less as the pins. The pins are just a regular old sewing pin that I've knocked the head off with a pair of cutters. I'll just go up through his foot, not through my hand, just through his foot. Ow. Okay, let's try the other foot then. Didn't have to go all that far in, and just up above his ankle. Just shove the head of the pin up into there. Pliers to grab it. That's in there enough. I get some super glue, which if I was organized I would have already had out. My lack of organization is going to result in a whole bunch of jump cuts in this video, I'm sure. Anyways. Drop a glue out onto my board of colors. This is just an ancient piece of foam core that I use for so many things. Mixing two-part epoxy on mostly. So I just give him a little tiny drop of super glue there, standard CA. And set him off to the side to dry for a while. We'll come back to him later. Okay, now then, I've got a handful of colors here out of my vast accumulation of colors. What color should I do first? This guy's almost done, so I think I'm going to do his hiking staff. A tan, I guess. This isn't a precise science. I'm going to get too much out. I don't really need too much. I'll probably mix that with... So, on my fancy painting palette. Get a small brush. What should I paint? Okay, this guy's jacket that he's his overcoat. What have I got in my paints here? I'll give him a camel coat. Is that what that means? I don't know. I've heard that term before. Maybe it is. That's what it means to me. That's what's going to happen. Ooh, yes, my awesome old paints. Little blob of that on my palette, along with other blobbiness. Relatively fine paintbrush. Okay, I'm gonna get busy here. Where is the camera? There we go. If somebody's looking so close that they can see my paintbrush strokes or something, they're looking way too close. 3-foot rule applies. On the other hand, I do want it to be better quality than those people in the off-the-shelf kit from Model Power or Lifelike or whoever that's from. Wow, I suck at making videos. Anyway, so there's his coat. He needs his hair painted too. Don't know what color I'm going to paint it. Cleaning, dab it off my paper towel that you can't see because it's off the frame. What color of hair should he get? I don't know, I'll worry about that later. Okay, looks like he gets brown hair. That's not too bad. How many other people have I got with brown hair here? Most of them I haven't decided yet. Okay, fair enough. Yeah, there's the colors of glare, glare, glare. There's that brown. That's okay, I guess. Hair can be that color on a guy in a suit with an overcoat and a hat. Yeah, that'll do. What else? Where's this guy over here? There's the guy that we glued into the pin earlier. That gives him... Actually, I'm going to mix some of that brown. A bit of this tan, just to lighten it up a little bit. A reasonable hair color? Hard to tell. I guess that'll do. Park him for later. That's one thing about having a bunch of them on the go, and about using this acrylic paint. It dries quickly. Which is nice, because you can keep going. Where's my flesh tone here? It dries fairly quickly. Yeah, I just forgot who I was going to paint. Yeah, the hiker guy. So you can keep going. And his staff's already dry. Oh yeah, it dries quickly, which is handy if you're doing a bunch of painting. But even if you just batch, you're doing like one color on every place that you're going to use it, and rinsing your brush out. Which is what I also do sometimes. You can just, paint one color on a bunch of different things, rinse off your brush and walk away for a few hours, let them dry and come back. You don't have to because it's a very quick drying paint. Okay, now the hard part. So here are some of the guys that have been painting so far today. girl on bench I haven't touched today. She just needs flesh tone, I guess. Suppose I could stop being lazy and deal with her too. Yes.